number one, Italy, two, Canada, three, Algeria, four, Argentina, five, Lithuania. The referee is Andrew Caulfield from Great Britain. And the boxers come to us from Kazakhstan and Ukraine. Please give them a very warm welcome, and here they come.
Approaching the boxing ring for this men's 81 kilogram light heavyweight semi-final is the tournament number three seed, the seventh ranked boxer in the world in the light heavyweight division, Kazakhstan's Adilbek Niyazymbetov. Kazakhstan flags being waved in the crowd. There's a sizable contingent of Kazakh fans on hand here at the XL Arena. And his opponent from Ukraine, a man who had been really impressive en route to this Olympic semi-final, Oleksandr Gvozdyk. Really efficient, really neat, really accurate with the work he's demonstrated so far.
Yeah, he's impressed me, the Ukraine. He's tall for the weight, doesn't give nothing away, doesn't make a lot of mistakes. And Niyazymbetov, a Kazakh boxer who himself is of quality, and they've got a very strong team here at these Olympics.
Ukraine have a seven-man boxing team here. Kazakhstan, their boxing squad totals 11, nine men and two women. The opening bell sounds in this men's 81 kilogram light heavyweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red, operating out of the southpaw stance representing Kazakhstan, Adilbek Niyazymbetov, 23 years of age, the silver medalist from the World Amateur Boxing Championships in Baku, Azerbaijan last year, and his opponent from Ukraine, boxing out of the orthodox stance and wearing blue, is Oleksandr Gvozdyk. 25 years of age, you can see the slight advantage he possesses in terms of height and reach, and he's used those attributes to terrific effect during the course of this Olympic tournament.
Yeah, Gvozdyk is very neat and tidy, and he doesn't make many mistakes. Got through with a lovely right hand there, and the problem that he will find here against Niyazymbetov is he's against a southpaw who sits back, so the gap is increased, and that right hand of his has got to travel further to the target, so he's got to get those feet in close. But of course, you come on to shots as well, so he's got to watch what he's doing, the man in blue, coming forward.
The man in blue has looked really impressive during his progression to this semi-final stage, never more so than in his contest in the quarter-final against the tournament number two seed, Algeria's Abdelhafid Ben Chabla, when he won by a scoreline of 19 points to 17. A wonderful exhibition and demonstration of competitive boxing of the highest skill level. And then, with the clock showing zero, as he gets with a cracking right hand on Niyazymbetov. With the clock showing zero, the referee called stop and issued a public warning against Ben Chabla. And when the final score was announced, that of course meant 2 points onto the score of Gvozdyk. And when the score was announced, just a moment later, it was 19 points to 17 in favour of Gvozdyk. That public warning making all the difference in the outcome of that bout.
Yeah, a very lucky boy indeed. But here, he's getting the tactics right. He's getting close to his opponent. I just think Niyazymbetov, he's waiting a little bit too long. That was a better shot from him. But he just waits a little bit too long for me. He's got to respond quicker with his counters.
Niyazymbetov the reigning World Championship silver medalist, where he lost to Julio Cesar de la Cruz of Cuba in the final. De la Cruz eliminated at the quarter-final stage, of course, by the Brazilian Yamaguchi Falcao in what has to go down as the biggest upset of the tournament so far. And that blew the top half of the draw wide open in this men's 81-kilogram light heavyweight division. Would have loved the opportunity now Niyazymbetov to try and avenge that defeat in the gold medal bout, but there's no assurance that he's going to make it because he is tied in this semi-final bout against Oleksandr Gvozdyk. The scoreline is knotted at 4 after the first round of boxing.
Yeah, nothing in it at all. I think Gvozdyk's tactics are good in that he's coming forward and he's trying to score with that right hand, and we see it there in this sequence. That's better, but his feet are a little bit too slow, and that's allowing Niyazymbetov to actually land with shots. Again there, Gvozdyk lands with that right hand, getting the feet nice and close. But slow feet means that Niyazymbetov is suited to the pace. So Gvozdyk, for me, he's got to probably quicken up a little bit. Remember that counter-punching southpaw style, likes that more leisurely pace, and it's just suiting the man in red, in my opinion, just slightly.
Into the second round we go. It's the men's 81-kilogram light heavyweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red, the tournament number 3 seed and 7th-ranked boxer in the world in the light heavyweight division. That is Kazakhstan's Adilbek Niyazymbetov. His opponent, wearing blue, operating out of the orthodox stance, is Oleksandr Gvozdyk of Ukraine. Good right hand from Gvozdyk. And at the end of the first round of boxing, there was absolutely nothing to separate these two. It was tied at 4 points apiece.
I think Niyazymbetov here, Ronald, has got to also target the straight left hand to the body. When you have an orthodox man coming forward like Gvozdyk is doing here, look how tall he is, he's open downstairs. You need a little feint with the right hand, the lead hand, and then whip a left, straight left to the body and finish with the right up to the head. Because he's coming forward, he'll actually walk onto the shot because he's closing the gap himself.
Good use of the feet by Sapiev. There was a good left hand to the body. It was a bolo he tried to turn into a left hook to the head. The second shot just going a little bit long. It's Gvozdyk remaining on the front foot. Niyazymbetov, his back just skimming the ropes around the perimeter. Good little left hook landed on the inside, and a follow-up right cross wasn't too far away from Gvozdyk as well. Good right hand straight down the pipe from Gvozdyk. And again, that efficiency that he's demonstrated as he lands another good right hand. The efficiency Gvozdyk had demonstrated all tournament long, in evidence once again here in this semi-final.
Yeah, his accuracy is superb, isn't it, Gvozdyk? And I think now he's up the work rate a little bit now. He's changing tempo for the Ukraine, paying dividends.
Inside the final minute of this second round, in a contest that was tied at 4 points apiece at the end of the first, could just take on a little bit of a different complexion at the end of this second round, because as this second round has progressed, Gvozdyk has just up the work rate. His accuracy has been superb, as it has been all tournament long. And Niyazymbetov just being reduced to flailing and missing with his shots. Gvozdyk on the front foot once more. Niyazymbetov ties his man up before getting back to ring center.
Yeah, you just get the sense that Niyazymbetov is struggling here with the pace. He's a little bit lazy as well, the Kazakhstan boxer. This is better from the Ukraine. He senses that. He's on the front foot. He's pushing. He's pushing the tempo in the fight now. And this is a better contest now for Gvozdyk.
So as the bell sounds, to end that second round, it was tied at 4 points apiece at the end of one. but it's Gvozdyk in the blue corner who has eked out a one-point lead to lead by a scoreline of 10 points to 9.
Well, Niyazymbetov is very lucky here to be going into the third round, only one behind, because there was some boos in the crowd, and I agreed with him. I think Gvozdyk should be ahead more here. Niyazymbetov did land with the odd shot, but the man in blue coming forward time and again, landing with that right hand. And that Kazakhstan corner will feel themselves lucky, or should feel lucky. And there's that little right hand to the body. He really felt that one. Did the Niyazymbetov. Long right hand. Sorry, long left hook from Gvozdyk. And this fella should be a couple more points ahead.
Into the third and final round of this men's 81 kilogram light heavyweight semi-final we go. The boxer wearing blue, Oleksandr Gvozdyk, on the front foot, operating out of the orthodox stance. He's leading the tournament number 3 seed and reigning world championship silver medalist Adilbek Niyazymbetov from Kazakhstan by just one single solitary point after two rounds of boxing. But again, it's Gvozdyk who is beginning the third round in similar vein to be demonstrated in the last. But look at the response from Niyazymbetov, who just, as he got shoved backward, betrayed weary legs there. But Gvozdyk remaining as compact and poised as ever, despite the towering height he possesses in this division. His defense is always tight, his punches are always correct, and more often than not, they are unerringly accurate.
Yeah, I think the accuracy is the difference here. Gvozdyk starting to land with better quality shots. What he's got to do now, as he's throwing that right hand, he's got to slow the feet down a little bit. He's just moving a little bit too close to Niyazymbetov, who then holds him. So he's just got to just maintain the gap when he throws that right hand. Got to keep well balanced. Lovely short right uppercut to the body there from Gvozdyk.
Gvozdyk appeared to enjoy a really commanding second round. Niyazymbetov had his moments as well. And at the end of that second round, Gvozdyk led by just one. So can Niyazymbetov take advantage and get his nose in front in an effort to make the gold medal bout in the light heavyweight division? They've had success in this division before, have Kazakhstan, with Vasily Jirov in Atlanta in 1996. And he took the title in the light heavyweight class. How he would love to emulate that, but he's got his hands full here as Niyazymbetov, the reigning world championship silver medalist, with the man from the Ukraine, Oleksandr Gvozdyk, whose fitness levels must be absolutely superb, because there's never any deterioration in his work.
No, but the fitness levels of the man in red are really deteriorating. It's quite plain to see. He's hanging on now and trying to buy time. But for me, the momentum is with Gvozdyk. And I think he's turned this around. I think he's winning this now.
Approaching the final 30 seconds of this semi-final, the winner, of course, will progress through to the gold medal bout in the 81 kilogram light heavyweight division. Good right, good shot from Gvozdyk.
Yeah, what am I talking about? He hasn't turned it around. He's increased it, should I say. He went into this final round 1 point ahead. But now the signs are there, aren't they? This Kazakhstan boxer keeps holding on. Gvozdyk coming forward, and another shot there.
Beautiful right hand just snapped the head back of Niyazymbetov, who is becoming increasingly weary as we approach this final bell. He takes a short left hook on the inside and a chopping little right hand, and then is keen to initiate a clinch once more. Is Niyazymbetov, and surely Gvozdyk has done enough with another demonstration of really impressive boxing. That was accurate, full of accurate work, efficient punching, and that's an example of what he's been doing all tournament long.
Yeah, superb straight right hand. More accurate work came from the man in blue. Misses with the left hook, but certainly got home with that right hand. The momentum was with him, pushing his man back. Clash of heads here. Sometimes you get that with an orthodox boxer coming forward against the southpaw. For me, there's only one winner, and he's the man with the blue vest on.
There was only 1 point in it as we entered this third and final round. And Gvozdyk produced another impressive display in that third round, a round in which again Niyazymbetov had his moments, but the greater quality and indeed the greater quantity of work came from this boxer, Oleksandr Gvozdyk, as we await the announcement to see who will progress through to the gold medal bout in the light heavyweight division here at London 2012.
Joking.
The winner, Gavlak, in the red corner, representing
Adilbek Niyazymbetov has booked his place in the Olympic gold medal bout. He prevailed on countback. It was tied at 13 points apiece, according to the judges, at the end of the bout. And Oleksandr Gvozdyk, who boxed superbly during the course of that contest, particularly in round 2 and 3, has somehow lost the final round.